Okay, welcome class. In this video now, we are going to deal with the concept of correction of errors. Correction of errors. So, if you can observe now, they are saying these questions are favored with the examiners. But it is not possible to frame a concise set of rules to deal with this sort of problem. The best approach is to ask the following questions, okay? I'm going to do it in my own way. The basic double entry bookkeeping, you all understand about that. I just want to deal starting from this number 4. If you check number 4, there is a question there. Yes, the error affected the sales or purchases ledger. So in other words, you are saying, yes, the error affected the sales ledger account. Meaning to say an error can affect the ledger. Oh, the question is, the error affected the control. So an error can affect the sales ledger without affecting the sales ledger control. Or an error can affect the control without affecting the ledger. So in other words, there is a difference between the sales ledger and the sales ledger control, which is the receivables ledger and the receivables control. Also the purchases ledger and the purchases ledger control. So what's the difference between those two? If we check, when we are correcting errors, correction of errors, let's first distinguish. We have got what we call the sales ledger. The sales ledger, that's your personal account of customers. Or that's your individual account. Or we can call it list of balances. That's your schedule of receivables. Then, number 2, we have got what you call the receivables or sales ledger control, or that's your total account. So there is a difference between a personal account and the control account. Let's explain the difference, okay? Let me show you diagrammatically the difference between the two. When you are dealing with the let me show you using this diagram. The main difference using this diagram. Okay. If you can observe from that diagram, which I've put on the board, you can actually see that we have a sales day book. We also have sales returns book. We have a cash book. Both accounts are our personal accounts. Remember, these are books of prime entry. That's where a transaction, I said, is first recorded before it's transferred to the ledger. So if transactions are first recorded in the books of prime entry, we now transfer them to the ledger. If you observe here, Alec, we now open in the sales ledger, we open Alec's account, which is an individual account. We record all transactions relating to Alec. Then we balance it off here. We also open Betty's account, where we record Betty's individual transactions in the business. We also open Charles' account, where we record Charles' individual transactions with the business. You can open, that's the ledger. Okay, then the same information now. So when we are preparing the ledger, we are recording transaction in individual account of the customers. But when we are now preparing the control, we just take the totals of the book of prime entries. For example, if you check this 45 here, that's the one which is now transferred. We now record it in the receivables ledger control. So when you are preparing the control, we just take the 45. Then, for example, again, the sales return. When we are preparing the sales ledger, we are taking individual accounts, 8, 3, to individual accounts. But when we are now preparing the control, we just take the total 11, then we transfer it. Okay? If you check again with the cash book, when we are preparing the sales ledger, we are transferring to individual account 6, 10, 9, to individual accounts of customers. But when we are now preparing the control, we just take the total of 25 and we transfer it to the control account. So you can observe that the main difference between a sales ledger and sales ledger control lies in the way in which they are prepared or how the information is extracted from the books of prime entry. So when you are preparing individual accounts, we are posting to individual, but when you are preparing the control account, we are taking the totals of the books of prime entry. That's when I say it, if we check, I was saying now, a sales ledger, that's your personal account, that's your individual list of balances, that's your schedule of receivables. Then the control, it's only the receivables control or total account. So that's the difference. So if we go back now to our first part, I was saying, if you check, so when you are correcting errors, first understand about the records affected. Yes, the error affected the sales ledger, or yes, the error affected the control account. So an error can affect the ledger without affecting the control, or an error can affect the control without affecting the ledger, or an error can affect both accounts. Both the ledger and the control. So, what's the easiest way for you to understand or for you to correct the errors? Okay, I'm going to deal with, remember, we are going to use that diagram. Okay, whenever you are correcting errors, number one, it is worth remembering the following point. It is worth remembering the following point. So, I'm going to deal with this point, explaining these points, which will assist you to understand the concepts better. I need you to understand these ones. So when you are dealing with this one, this will assist you so much. Okay. So the first thing, let me minimize. Okay. So the first one, is a transaction omitted from a book of prime entry. A transaction omitted from the book of prime entry will be omitted from the personal account in the ledger and from the control account. Let's check with our diagram. For example, if this alert chain is not recorded in this book of prime entry, definitely it will also be omitted here. And it will also be omitted from the total. If we don't include this term here, it will be omitted from the ledger, and it will also be omitted from the total of the control account. So if a transaction is omitted from the book of prime entry, the same error will be repeated in the personal account in the ledger, and it will also be repeated in the control. Number two, a transaction entered incorrectly in a book of prime entry will result in the error being repeated in the personal account in the ledger and in the control. Let's go to the diagram. For example, if this chain, let me show you practical part. Let me put a marker here. Okay, let's go back to our source. So, if this term is recorded, for example, as 20, then the one to be transferred to the ledger to be transferred as 20, and the total here, instead of being 45, it becomes 55. So this same total also be carried forward to the control S55. Then, if you go to the third item to remember, a transaction copied incorrectly from a book of prime entry to a personal account will not affect the control. Okay? Let's go to the diagram. For example, if this alleged transaction has been recorded as 10 here, instead of being recorded as 10, it's recorded as 15 in the personal account. There is 10 in the book of prime entry. Remember, I said a transaction copied incorrectly from the book of prime entry. So in the book of prime entry, it's correct, it's 10. But when it's now transferred to the ledger, it's recorded here as 15. We record it here as 15. This will not affect the control. Why? Because when we are recording transactions in the control, we just take the total of the book of prime entry. So if the book of prime entry is correct, then it will not affect the total of the ledger. Then, lastly, an error in the addition of the book of prime entry. An error in the addition of a book of prime entry affects the control account, but not to the personal account. Let's show it diagrammatically. I'm saying, for example, there is 10, 20, 15 here. Then you make an additional error, then you get this S55. This is not going to affect the ledger. Why? Because we just take 10, we just take 20, we just take 15, transferring them to the individual account. But the control now, when we are now taking this total of 55, it will be recorded incorrectly in the control. So this error does not affect the personal account. So in summary, we are saying, number one, if a transaction is omitted from the book of prime entry, it will also be omitted in the personal account, in the control account. If a transaction is entered incorrectly into a book of prime entry, it will result in the error being repeated in the personal account, in the ledger, in the control. Then if a transaction is copied incorrectly from a book of prime entry to a personal account, it will not affect the control. Then lastly, an error in the addition of the book of prime entry affects the control account, but not the personal account.